here. Sorry, I'm wiping off my camera here. I'm doing a quick video, or it's not really a quick video, a video of me on the Omaha Trail. This is a beautiful trail in literally my backyard up here in Wisconsin. It's 100 miles long. I'm only going to show you guys bits and pieces of it. I can only do 6 miles of it, so that's all I'm going to show you. But anyway, I just wanted to let you guys know what I'm doing here. This is gorgeous. The leaves are changing. It's October. It's very windy. It's kind of chilly. But again, I just wanted to show you guys the trail here and just walk with me. So I hope you enjoy. Thanks for watching. See you soon. I wanted to show you. These are my shoes. The Hoka. Hoka One Ones. I don't know. But anyway, you can see this is, it's paved trail. And again, it's 100 miles. You know, there's stops here and there on it. This is still in my town, so you can still see like houses and stuff to the right. And that's Sheena in front of me. Turn around and say hi, Sheena. Sheena's my Sheena's my running partner. She's out here with me. So it's extremely windy out today, and you can hear the train. I apologize, but look at all the beautifulness of the trees are changing. So I'm just gonna stop the video here and then pick it up in a little bit when I get further down and show you some more sights. Anyway, again, I thought this would be a lot of fun, and I'm talking over a train, so I'm gonna stop and I'll be back. All right, I'm back. I'm just wanting to pan around and just show the beautiful cutouts of the rocks on the trail here, and then the leaves are changing, and I'm not that far. See, you can see where I started. I'm literally not that far, but I'm just now in the getting into the trail, and I'm gonna try to keep these clips very short because I'm gonna put them all together into one video. But I just wanted to share this with everybody because it's gorgeous up here in Wisconsin, and the leaves are changing, and this is in my backyard. And I guess with me getting older, I'm really appreciating my surroundings, and it's just so gorgeous. I don't know if you can see the clouds, and you know, this is just beautiful. So just sharing this with everybody. So I'm gonna say goodbye for now, and I will be back with some more of the beautiful Omaha Trail up here in Wisconsin. See you in a little bit. I think I'm a mile up now. I just wanted to show some beautiful color here. We got some red. It's super windy, so I wanted to do this before all the leaves fell off, but we just started changing, so the leaves are going to change much more drastically in the next week. They'll be much more beautiful. So anyway, I just wanted to show. I'm going to stop here. Whew, I'm out of breath. Isn't that gorgeous? Just want to show some scenery. You can see how that wraps around. And there's Sheena again. She's got their camelback on, so we got our water. We're out here getting our exercise on. So, God, it's so pretty. I hope this is coming through on the video, how beautiful this is here. And I just wanted to share this with everybody. I'm gonna try to keep these clips very short though, because I think I'm gonna go 4 miles up and just kind of splice them all together. So, this is so pretty. I can't see because the sun's in my eyes, but I'm gonna try to get that and just pray it comes through. God, that is so gorgeous. So again, I hope you guys enjoy this. This is, like I said, totally different type of video than I usually do. But again, whatever, you know, just sharing some of the Wisconsin beauty with you guys. So, all right, see you in a little bit. I'm gonna head up a little further. Bye. Hopefully the wind's not going to ruin this sound too much. It's windy, cold. But I just wanted to show you on the trail here, you know, we are farmland up here too. There's this one little break where we're farmland. So just wanted to show how pretty that is. Golly. Huh? Sheena's pointing out to stand this way to show that the trees are changing up there, but I just wanted to show that they're plowing the fields. So, all right, I'm going to go back up. It is so stinking windy. I'll be right back. We're coming up on one of many bridges on the trail. I hope this is focusing okay. Sorry, I'm out of breath. This is 3 miles I'm in now, so I just stopped to walk a little bit so I can record some more at the trail. Again, this is Omaha Trail. Oh, look at the little squirrel. Omaha Trail in Wisconsin, it's gorgeous. So this one's a bridge, and this is a bike trail, or running trail. People run, walk, and bike on it. I just want to get some of the scenery for you to see how gorgeous it is. It's unseasonably warm this time of year for Wisconsin, and the trees are just starting to change, so I wanted to catch some of the changing before the wind blew it off. But I'm just gonna pan around here and get, sorry about it, wrapping. I don't know if it's capturing the colors. It's so pretty. So anyway, I'm 3 miles in. Just wanted to show one of the bridges. There's several dozen bridges on this. Well, more than that, because the trail's 100 miles long. So I do know of six bridges that I can cross on the little bit that I cover on foot. So anyway, I'm gonna get back to it. I will be back. So I hope you guys are enjoying this. Let me know. I can do more walk with me videos. This is just a vague one. I'm just showing a little bits and pieces here and there. So if you want me to do more and show more of the trail, maybe go further up, show the tunnels, show some more of the babbling brooks, I can do that before it gets too cold. So anyway, I will be back. 4 miles in. There is a rest area just ahead. You probably just saw the car go past. That's where my 4 mile mark is. I'm gonna go stop there and turn around. But in the meantime, I wanted to touch base. I showed you in the beginning, I am trying out these Hoka One One brand trail running shoes. This is probably 2 weeks I've been using these. I'm an A6 person. I love my A6 Gel Nimbus 17s. Those are a dream. But as you can see the terrain here, and when I go further up by the tunnel, it's like a straight 90 degree straight up grade. So it's a lot of climbing. So I needed something with a little more meat on it. You know, the A6 were great, but for $160 pair of shoes, you go through them pretty fast. These Hoka One One, these are the, Challenger ATRs. I'm gonna show them quickly. These are the ones that they wanted me to try. I'm gonna tell you right now, I was first turned off by the, you can see it looks like there's quite a lot of, they reminded me of a Skecher. And I was turned off by that, and I'm gonna tell you right now, they are not a Skecher, not even a little bit. They're a lot like an Ultra, where they have the zero drop. I'll have to get the specs. I don't remember offhand. I didn't know I was gonna be doing this, but I just thought I'd mention it. These actually are less inclined than the A6, which were giving me shin splints. These shoes were designed by Olympic runners who suffer from shin splints, and I was told that these would help. And so far, they've been amazing. Anyway, I just wanted to touch base on that. I am almost at my 4-mile mark. As you can see, it's right there. And then I'm going to turn around and come back. So again, I just wanted to touch base on these shoes because I know a lot of you who are going to be watching this particular video are probably athletes. You probably do running. You probably do a lot of bike riding. I wouldn't suggest these for bikes, but trail, definitely. Hiking, definitely. And running, definitely. I mean, I've used these on street. I haven't tried them on a treadmill, but I have used them on the street. They're very light. They are actually the same weight as my Asics Gel Nimbus 17s. So, and again, I don't have the specs in my head. I'm just winging it here. So, anyway, I will be back with some more on the way back. So, I hope you guys are enjoying this. Again, this is Omaha Trail. It is October, and I think it's the 15th, Wisconsin. Beautiful day, but windy. And I'm just sharing the scenery and sharing my walk run with you guys. I guess call it a walk run since I'm stopping about every mile, which is fine because this is a lot of fun. Anyway, I will be back. Just want to show that beautiful. Back on the trail, heading home. I'm about, I don't know, maybe a mile and a half from the house. So just wanted to show this little area here. Well, the wind was dying down because, again, I don't know how this video is going to turn out with the wind blowing. I'm recording with my phone, so hopefully it didn't ruin the video. But isn't that so beautiful? So much woods. It's just gorgeous here. I love it in Wisconsin. So pretty. I might stop here with the recording and come back and see if we can get the bluffs because we have so many beautiful bluffs in my area. If I can't get them, you won't see them. But I will try to get some of the bluffs. I also live in what's called the Driftless Zone. You can Google it. Again, I'm not prepared with the information on it. But basically, it's during the ice age, we did not ice over here. So we have beautiful cutouts. And that's why we're referred to as the Driftless Zone. And that's what I wanted to try to get some footage of because it's so pretty. Anyway, I don't know. I'm going to zoom. Just see. Again, this is in October, 2015. The leaves just started changing in the last, I want to say last 2 weeks, maybe week and a half. So they have not fully changed yet. This is just, they're going to get much more beautiful. These are part of the bluffs right here, and you can't really see them because the leaves are all there. But as soon as like the leaves fall off, it's beautiful cut out mountains up there. Anyway, I'll be back. There's the trail. I'm heading home. So see you guys in a little bit. I hope this is not destroying this, but I'm going to try to zoom in. You can see what I was talking about with the bluffs. You can't, maybe not. I don't know. But the leaves are just starting to get really pretty. That's all mountainous cutout rock formation. I don't know if you can see. I can't really zoom anymore. And it's just gorgeous here. So anyway, back to my walk. So I'll be back. I'm just taking some video. I'm almost at the mouth of the trail. This is where I just came from. There's Sheena. She's ahead of me. I don't know if you can see right above her where the light is. That's the mouth of it to my little town. And then I will be walking back home and I'll be done. So I just wanted to get some video of this gorgeous, gorgeous day. When you live up in Wisconsin, you really appreciate the beautiful days before it snows, because when the snow comes, I'm stuck on my treadmill. I'm stuck. Oh, focus. Come on. Okay. I'm stuck on my treadmill. I'm stuck in the house. So you just learn to appreciate and love the days before the snow comes, which honestly, last year this time we had about 3 feet of snow on the ground. So this is great. I'm loving this. So anyway, I am going to head home now. I hope you guys enjoyed my little walk with me type show you the Omaha Trail, or I should say a portion of it, video. Let me know in the comments if you want to see more or give any questions. Just let me know. This was a lot of fun. Yeah, I've been walking this for quite a while now, for about a year. And shout out to my girl Raquel, down in Arizona, girl. She got me out of the house and said, you know what, you live in beautiful God's country up there, get out there and explore. And this has been in my backyard, it's embarrassing to say, for 9 years. And I've only been taking advantage for a year. So, anyway, thank you, Raquel, for getting me out of the house and get me off that dreaded treadmill. Ick. So, anyway, I don't know. I might do maybe one more shot, because I do live in a really cute little town, and maybe you can see the bluffs when I cross the tracks. Because, like I said, this used to be railroad tracks. This is from the 1800s, and they paved it, so the tracks have literally been moved over. So when I'm off the trail, which, as you can see, almost ended now, I will be crossing the tracks, and then it's just a picturesque, I can't even speak, I'm out of breath, little town that I live in, with the bluffs and the cutouts, and it's just gorgeous. So anyway, again, if this is the last time I see you guys, or I don't know if I'm going to come back, I might, whatever. If I do, I do. If I don't, I don't. Thank you all who have watched this and stuck it out with me and watched the whole thing. Comment below if you have any questions. If you want me to do more, let me know. This was just, I'm kind of testing this out. I've never done anything like this before, so this is my first one. But, all right, I will see you guys later. Say bye, Sheena.
Bye.
Just the very last part of the video here. I am just showing you where there's the train tracks. Literally, the mouth of the trail is right there. So from there to there is where they move the tracks. And I just wanted to show you the beautiful bluffs in my area. So anyway, this is going to be the end. Now you can see the star up on the top. They really light that at night. But I'm going to try to stop shaking the camera here and just zoom it in. So anyway, I just had to share that with you guys. I love that old look of the old barn. Let's zoom it out, back out here. So just going to do a quick pan. Almost home. I'm going to actually upload the video, put it together, see how it turned out. And if you guys are all watching it, then it must have came out nice. So again, everybody who has watched and listened and put up with this, thank you so much. I appreciate it. Comment below if you have any requests, or if you want to see more of the Omaha Trail, let me know. Let me know how you like the video. Such a beautiful day. So anyway, don't know if you can see those bluffs there. They are just, it's just beautiful here. I just love this area. It's just gorgeous. Cold, but beautiful. So anyway, again, thank you so much, everybody, for watching. Comment below. Like the video if you like it. Otherwise, talk to you later. Thanks. Bye.